topic is front of leg and its muscles, vessels and nerves. In this we discuss the competency, that is muscles of anterior compartment of leg, their attachment, nerve supply and action. Another competency that is discussed in this are the important nerves and vessels of anterior compartment of leg. And the third competency that is discussed in this is anatomical basis of foot drop. First, we'll start with muscles of anterior compartment of leg. The muscle we are discussing is tibialis anterior. This muscle takes origin from tibia and adjacent interosseous membrane, and it is inserted into medial cuneiform bone and the base of first metatarsal. Coming to action of tibialis anterior, it helps in dorsiflexion of the foot, it helps in maintaining transverse arch of foot, and the nerve is deep peroneal nerve, also called as deep fibular nerve. Another muscle which is discussed is extensor digitorum longus. It takes origin from lateral condyle of tibia, the head and anterior crest of fibula, and adjacent part of interosseous membrane. It is inserted into second to fifth digits, that is into terminal phalanges. Then action is dorsiflexion of foot and also toes. The nerve supply is deep peroneal nerve. The next muscle is extensor hallucis longus. Origin is medial surface of fibula and adjacent interosseous membrane. Insertion is into first digit terminal phalanx, that is big toe. Action is extension of the big toe and dorsiflexion of the foot. Nerve supply is deep peroneal nerve. So then we go to discuss the nerve, and the nerve here is called as deep peroneal nerve. It is a mixed sensory as well as motor nerve. This nerve innervates anterior compartment of leg and also extensor digitorum brevis. The nerve is subcutaneous, so it is susceptible for trauma. Coming to position of the deep peroneal nerve, that is, it is anterior to anterior tibial vessels. This is the relation. It is anterior to anterior tibial vessels. Applied anatomy. Complete transection of the nerve within the distal third of leg results in mild motor deficits, while there is loss of sensation in the first interspace. There is one syndrome called as anterior tarsal syndrome or anterior tarsal tunnel syndrome. It is the compression of deep peroneal nerve in the ankle or foot. The structures implicated as the cause of compression are inferior extensor retinaculum, the superior border of superior extensor retinaculum, tendon of extensor hallucis brevis, and also tightly laced shoes. Then we go to study the anterior tibial artery. It is smaller or weaker anterior branch of popliteal artery. Coming to beginning, it begins immediately below the popliteus muscle. Termination, it terminates opposite the inferior extensor retinaculum, where it continues as dorsalis pedis artery or dorsal pedi artery, dorsal pedal artery or dorsalis pedis artery. course. It traverses the superior opening of interosseous membrane of the leg to enter anterior compartment of leg. That is, it comes from posterior to anterior. Then it runs vertically downwards, adhering to the anterior surface of interosseous membrane. And anterior tibial artery runs in company with the two committent veins and deep peroneal nerve. Coming to branches, the branches of anterior tibial artery are posterior recurrent tibial, anterior recurrent tibial, anterior medial malleolar, and anterior lateral malleolar. These are the branches of the anterior tibial artery. Termination. The ending branch of anterior tibial artery is called as dorsalis pedis artery. Then we come to anatomical basis of explanation of anatomical basis of foot drop. So we start with the common peroneal nerve course. The common peroneal nerve leaves the sciatic nerve in the distal thigh. Then it lies on the biceps femoris muscle on its way to the popliteal fossa. Then it is superficial and lies on bony prominences like lateral femoral condyle, the head of fibula, the neck of fibula. Then it runs in a tunnel, that is fibro-osseous tunnel, at the level of fibular neck. Then it passes deep to or below the tendineous origin of peroneus longus and enters one tunnel that is called as peroneal tunnel, which is there between the two heads of the peroneus longus muscle. Coming to branches, proximal to the fibular head, it gives sural communicating branch. As the nerve enters the peroneal tunnel, it divides into deep, superficial, and recurrent peroneal nerves. Then coming to anatomical basis of foot drop, these nerves spread over the periosteum of the fibular neck and are covered by tendineous origin of peroneus longus muscle. The plantar flexion or ankle dorsiflexion tenses peroneus longus and compresses the nerve in the tunnel against fibula neck. Then we go to study the superficial peroneal nerve, which is branch of common peroneal nerve. It courses distally, lying on anterior intermuscular septum. It supplies peroneal muscles. Then at the junction of middle and distal third of tibia, the nerve pierces the fascia, that is called pleural fascia, that is the leg fascia, and splits into two cutaneous branches. The nerve may be compressed in the leg when it is piercing the fascia, that is named as superficial peroneal nerve syndrome. And coming to branches of the superficial peroneal nerve, its branches provide sensation to anterolateral leg, dorsum of the foot, and dorsal skin of great, second, third, and fourth toes. And finally, coming to anatomical basis, the injury to the main trunk of the common peroneal nerve in the region of peroneal tunnel frequently is caused by external compressive sores such as tight plaster casts, Even sitting in a prolonged position, prolonged cross-legged position, can also result in its lesion. Thank you.